Here's a little project that I put together for fun. It's a very basic portable power supply, which is good for charging your phone, computer, or media devices on the go if you're somewhere that doesn't have an electrical power source. Picnics and camping come to mind. You can tailor your power box for specific needs and requirements, but here's a basic parts list that I used for mine. A battery box. I specifically picked this type because it's adjustable for different sized batteries and easily leaves space for extra wires needed for this project. A battery. I picked this one up cheap, but if you're going to be using your power box frequently, I'd suggest a deep cycle battery so you don't wear your battery out too quickly. A solar power connector. You only need this if you'll be charging your device using solar power or you'd like the option to be able to do so. Electric battery charger. The one I selected is really for maintaining the charge of a battery and storage. It wouldn't hurt to pick up something a bit stronger, but I picked this up pretty cheap and I thought I'd give it a try. 12-volt combo USB port, cigarette lighter, blue LED, voltmeter. Off and on power switch. This is so your power isn't running down your battery constantly. Mine'll be set up so that all my devices can all be switched off while the battery is charging. Ring terminals. Inline fuse holder to prevent any potential damage to your battery from a possible power overload. Fuses. 14-gauge black and red electrical wire. 14-gauge is generally acceptable for the basic devices that will be wired to the battery. Push-in wire connectors. I picked these up because of their ease of use for the project. You can basically daisy-chain everything together quite easily without making too much of a mess. And it's easy to go back and move something around later on if you decide to add or change something. I used 2 and 3 port connectors for the wiring. Female disconnects. I used these for connecting the wiring to the ports and power switch. The tools I used are pretty basic. I used a wire stripper, some pliers with wire cutters, and needle nose pliers. You don't really need the needle nose pliers though. I used a drill with spade bits for drilling holes in the battery box. Here's a basic schematic of how I'll be wiring the portable power box. To simplify things, I'll be piecing it together before hooking up the ports, switch, and battery. This way I won't have to reach around in the battery box and wire things. Wiring it this way is a bit less restrictive, movement-wise. Beginning the actual construction, I started out by measuring placement and using the plate that came with the port attachments as a template. I then drew X's in the center of each circle to more easily line up the spade drill bits. After drilling each of the holes, I switched over to the wiring process. I started out the process by cutting 10 4-inch pieces of red-coated wire to be used for the positive connections between chargers, power switch, and ports. Then using the wire strippers, I stripped the ends off of both sides of each wire. You want to make sure to twist the wires on each end to make the wires easier to thread into the female disconnects as well as the push-in wire connectors. Then I just followed the wiring chart and placed female disconnects in position where each of the ports and power switch would be connected later. The female disconnects slide easily over the wires, and then you can connect them by pressing them firmly into place with the pliers. These are the ring terminals I used for connecting the battery. I connected this end to a 12-inch piece of black wire to be used for connecting the negative side of the battery to the negative connections on the charger, power switch, and ports. As long as you keep the negative wires black and connect them only to the negative connectors on the attachments and wire them directly to the negative side of the battery, it's all relatively simple and you don't run the risk of burning anything out. I wired the electric and solar chargers directly into the push-in wire connectors, making sure that the negative side of the chargers was connected to the negative side of the wiring and the positive to the positive. So I connected the ring terminal directly to the inline fuse holder and wired it directly to the battery. So if anything goes wrong in any of the wiring process, the fuse will blow and prevent any problems or overloads. The fuse I selected was a 30 amp fuse, while the battery I'm using is rated for 275 amps. So if anything were wired wrong, the fuse would blow long before there was any real danger of damaging the battery. You'll notice I repeated the exact same process as before, cutting several black wires at approximately 4 inches in length to be used for the negative connection wires. The reason I daisy-chained all of the wiring before attaching anything to the charging unit was to make the construction easier. It was a simpler process to follow the wiring schematic and complete everything externally because it gave me a lot more room to piece everything together rather than doing it all in the cramped space inside the battery box. That left me with only attaching the female disconnects in tighter quarters. And since all the wiring is clearly marked as negative and positive, it made the process of attaching everything together a really simple process. For the next step, I popped in all of the attachments to be wired. I put them in order of my own preference and left the bracket that I used as a template out simply because I found the look of the power box more aesthetically pleasing without it. The power switch easily pops into place. For the other attachments, I flipped the battery box on its side to tighten the ring holders in place for each of the ports. Following the wire schematic, I attached each of the positive female disconnects to the ports and the power switch in the order shown, and then did likewise with the negative connections. I used the battery spacer to tuck all of the wires away from the battery, dropped the battery into place, and tucked the solar and electrical charger cords in. The ring terminals are bolted to the battery with a washer so that the small bolts I used don't slip out. The power box lit right up with the flip of a switch, so I'm confident that I wired everything correctly. The voltmeter shows the voltage and the USB ports light right up. I add another to test the cigarette lighter. Everything works good. Here's the finished result with the lid in place. I decided to test the USB charger on my phone, and it works great. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thanks for watching, and do great things.